Very
Hi
good.
there, folks. Myself and Hi-Fi Man have teamed up, and we are here tonight to bring you a rather unique experience. We're going to unbox something that is rather unique to the world of geekology, for sure. My name's Trev, I'm a geekologist, and the man behind the video camera is none other than Mark of Hi-Fi Man, and he has
Hello.
brought to me tonight the Shangri-La Junior. And tonight, for the first time, we are going to do a live unboxing. I do apologize, as Mark has quite rightly pointed out, I've already undone the extra bit of safeguarding that Hi-Fi Man have put on this. So yes, the tie-back plastic tabs have gone, I'm afraid, but that is the cheapest part of these things. Now we're on to the expensive stuff. So as you can see, we have in the Shangri-La Junior is enclosed in a huge, almost safe, combination safe suitcase, and we have not one, not two, but four clasps to undo before we can show you the goodies inside. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, the Shangri-La Junior in all its glory. Do you think it survived the journey from China? I'd imagine in this little
Well, if
fortress.
not, we'll sue the case people.
Yes, absolutely, Mark. So, a veritable fortress here is protecting this. Let's bring out the easiest thing first. What's this thing? Have we got a headphone stand here? Let's get this out of its little wrapping, and I suspect, am I right, Mark? This is the headphone stand,
That is indeed.
right? So let's put this down here and we'll do a little close up of that perhaps. Okay, so as we've brought the headphone stand out, then logically, obviously, we ought to put something on them. And I know that my people out there are headphone fans. So here we have the Shangri-La Junior electrostatic headphones. I've listened to these once or twice before. Obviously, these are a new pair. And here we have the typical Hi-Fi Man case, and for the first time in many, many months, these are finally out of their wrapping. They weigh virtually nothing. The electrostatic pins at the bottom weigh more than the earphones themselves, because the majority of the power is produced by the voltage that goes through these.
If we turn that just aside a little, you can see the kind
Yes.
of the shiny.
Yes.
See if we just kind of catch that the way the light.
And as Mark quite rightly points out, this is pretty special. There's sort of the honeycomb diaphragm cage inside. You can tell that these are itching to be let out. They are as cold as ice to start with. And yes, it looks like we have the usual Hi-Fi Man headband, but there's just a subtle bit of extra quality, perhaps, arguably, here, just present.
Yeah, I think, yeah, it's a slightly different texture from the normal other ones. Not quite sure what it is. I assume it's dead something.
You almost feel like you've gone from pleather to leather there, but nevertheless, they're beautiful. Let's put them down on our. Where did we put that?
We stuck that there.
Okay. So shall we try and see if we can get this right? Am I doing this right?
Yeah.
Go this way round.
Yep. That's the way they sit.
And then they should quite pleasantly sit. Without any fear of them falling over.
Yeah.
And we can get a.
Although they are not resting on perhaps the world's most stable base, but.
No, absolutely. But. Yeah, we can get just a little glimpse of this sort of brushed aluminium finish on them that's quite special. Just gives you a feel that maybe there is something pretty special there. So, with that done. The next, the real snazzy thing, the Shangri-La Junior is a system, and for every system that has a headphone, of course, you need to amplify the headphone with a headphone amplifier. So let's get this out as carefully as we can, and that is where the real weight lies. Yes, this weighs a ton, this case weighs an absolute ton, and it's the case weighs quite a bit, but obviously the Junior itself weighs nothing as a headphone, so therefore all of the gadgetry that makes that headphone so powerful must lie within the thing that it plugs into, and here, ladies and gents, is the Hi-Fi Man Junior. Headphone amplifier. Doesn't look quite as snazzy without those, does it? Maybe we should just give you a view of the front there. Whilst I've got the strength to be able to lift this thing, because I promise you it weighs a ton.
Yeah, there's a good chunk of metal in there.
We'll have a quick look around the back. Luckily, I've got some holders here. So there we go, we have the space for the two headphone inputs and the usual two analog ins. So we'll put that down very, very carefully there. And we'll put that somewhere a little bit more safe in a minute. And I presume that here are our tubes that go into each of the tube output sockets, and don't they look beautiful? And obviously one has,
yes, they're all an idiot's
guide
labeled.
As to where to put them. So what's the betting that A4 has to fit into A4?
So yeah,
can see, shall we do that?
And you can see there is, if a camera zooms.
So, let's hope that we can get this right. And presumably it just pushes down.
Yep. Usually they kind of go in with this sort of slight little wiggle.
That'll do. We're in as far as we need to go, I think, on that. Hopefully. When you're looking at stuff like this, the thing is what we're dealing with here is thousands of pounds worth of equipment. And so, yes, one puts a certain amount of torque in it, but you think, Mark? I think that went in a lot, with a lot more. It was a lot happier going in that way. So my feelings, my thoughts are, let's see how it feels going in this way.
Yeah, so it's effortless that way, which logic dictates. If it's effortless going in one way, that's the way we need to go in. And obviously the instruction manual is right there, but I mean, whoever's got time to listen to look at an instruction manual when you're dealing with an £8,000 piece of kit. So on we go. A2. They were a bit cruel, weren't they? Putting the actual lettering on the piece of equipment one way, but one has to put the tubes in the other way round.
You know why?
No, I don't. Go on.
Have a look at the tube.
Right.
See, if we have tube,
yes,
with the label,
yes,
and we turn it round the other way,
yes,
what do we see?
Half a man?
Yeah, so that goes to the front.
Hmm. I hear you, yeah. Which sort of looks a bit nicer than a sort of a rather cheap looking sort of A4 sticker or A2 sticker on it, doesn't it? Yeah, he is right, of course. Yeah. Oh, that's just so much less stress putting it in like that. Oh yes, it's soft as putty putting it in that way. Let's just start getting these properly back in where they came from, because else we're just going to lose track. Like I always do on all of these unboxings, I lose track of which goes where. And after I've made the film, I spend twice the amount of time trying to get it all sorted out, back in the order it came in. Obviously, all tubes are meant to be handled with extreme care, and you're not supposed to touch the filament overly, but the problem is with all tubes, you need to exert a slight bit of force to just get the things in.
So, yeah,
you know, they need to be handled to a certain extent.
Well, they do, and officially, as with I'm sure everybody who makes anything with tubes, we suggest you use the, you know, the little white cotton gloves.
Yes.
That of course everybody has to hand. Although I actually do. They came with the speakers that I bought.
And also, Mark, for all our viewers out there around the world, a word of warning. Just the same as a light bulb, a tube gets extremely hot. You start picking these up when they've just powered down, and they will burn your hand. And even with gloves on, they will burn your hand. So just bear that in mind if you're fiddling with them. Hi-Fi Man have chosen these tubes with extreme care. I think the likelihood of you tube rolling with this particular device is minimal, but there will be guys out there that might be tempted to do it. If you do it, remember, if I can ever pass anything on to you, please, you know, just leave them to cool down before you start touching them, because you will burn yourself. Not that I've ever done it, of course.
No. Oh. No. Things with pieces of metal so hot they glow red. Yes, of course, you should always touch those.
Yes. So we've got one more little box here, which I presume is, I'm going to very carefully open this, is our mains stuff. We don't need a tremendous amount of mains. I think we're looking at basically one main cable, aren't we, to power this. I think that's pretty much about all we need. Have a look. And there it is. Hopefully it's UK. Yes, 3-pin plug. So it's UK plug, 3-pin plug. And
of course, as with any hi-fi kettle lead, you can upgrade to your heart's content.
If people like, you know,
people love to upgrade power cables. Could make a fortune selling people power cables.
Now, my friend Dylan, almost a genius of audio engineering and an extreme enthusiast and hobbyist, will talk to you about balanced mains units to his heart's content. I haven't got into that. At the moment, we're just going to go with simple stupid. I'm going to plug this in and see what happens. Out of the way. Even putting this back together again to get it moved, it weighs a ton. Right, how that goes there. Everything needs to be very carefully handled when you're dealing with this sort of stuff. I always say, in terms of being careful about stuff, overkill it. And I'm aware of the fact that when I'm videoing as well, there are other distractions, and so you'll think, my God, the man's so deliberate. It's because I know that part of my brain is dealing with trying to present myself in a super stylish type of presentation way, but the other side is trying to say, right, do not drop this, do not fumble with it and damage it in any way. So that's why it looks like I'm being overly cautious with it, because I'm aware that one simple distraction and you've destroyed very expensive piece of equipment. And these things,
although don't worry, I'm sure FedEx will always have you beat in that regard.
Yes, of course, yes. Well, you know, why pass something when you can throw it? You know, that saves precious seconds, doesn't it? Okay. And by the way, that wasn't in regards to FedEx, just in case they want to sue me.
Yeah. Although in my particular case, I really was meaning FedEx.
Okay, thank you for that, Mark. Anybody else wants to chime in on that, feel free.
Yeah.
We have your sympathy.
Yes, yes. I have the photographic evidence, not of a Shangri-La Jr., but of an item which shall remain nameless that... Yes.
Which one day will be brought to you, folks.
We
I know exactly what Mark means, but, you know, obviously.
Yes. Quite how FedEx managed to smash it, including smashing ye gigantic cases, two of them. Yeah, but they did.
That takes some special skills, folks, I'm sure you'll agree. But these people have a lifetime of practice at it, and you know, if you're determined enough, you can break anything, no matter what.
Yeah, the consensus we came up with was they must have, when they were taking them off the plane, dropped them from the plane.
Or, alternatively, maybe as they were landing just before, they decided to just throw everything out to make the landing a bit easier. I don't know.
Okay.
But anyway,
well, yeah, you know,
good when we got to it.
Like some African food drop. You know, where they just open the back of the plane and just toss everything out. Maybe that's FedEx's new style. Yeah, who knows?
So, although this looks perfectly stable, of course, you know, we have to be careful. So, as I'm unravelling this...
Yeah, we'll maybe take the wine away.
This is the first time this has ever been switched on. And... just have a look at this. And plug it in. You see we've got the top arrow here, so it's not exactly rocket science to work out how to do it. Please read the manual, I beg of you.
Yeah. Normally, we suggest, you know, first time I would say you turn it in, just in case you have done something with the tubes, is leave everything unplugged. Then when you turn it on,
thank you.
And what you'll find is that the little power thing will change colour, or...
And here is flashing white.
It does the flashing. It's a different one that does the colour.
So here is flashing white, and presumably once the tubes are warmed up enough to put the
headphones in, they will go permanently white. Maybe that light will stop flashing.
Yeah, it's essentially, it's internally kind of warming itself up. Although,
and here we are. Did you hear that satisfying click? And now we have a pure white light.
Yeah. Although, if you ask the audio purists, they would probably say you want to maybe go away and leave the thing for 20, 30 minutes to let the tubes properly warm up. Although, if we...
What does Hi-Fi Man say, Mark?
Well, I say...
You're on the spot here.
I say... plug it in, and if you like how it sounds, then you're good to go. Because
sensible advice, as always.
If you've got so much time in your life, you can wait half an hour from switching it on to actually using it, then, well, good for you. But I don't.
So, well, today, for the first unveiling of the Hi-Fi Man Shangri-La Junior...
Just show... before we do it, if I can have light control, I'll see if we... can get it dark enough. Oh. Can we see?
We've got two lights on. Yes, you're right.
Okay, you can just see the tubes are just starting to glow.
Yes, yes.
Which I always find somehow pleasing.
Okay. So, Mark, very... finally showed us the Christmas lights there. I'm going to give Mark the opportunity to hear a Super Audio CD player for the first time. So this is a recent purchase from a Super Audio CD made by Denon several years ago, but still working perfectly and saved from a lifetime of imprisonment in a loft and sold on Facebook Marketplace to myself. We're going to play you a Super Audio CD of Sacred Love by Sting.
Is it the only Super Audio CD you possess?
No.
Really? I've got several. Wow.
I've got several.
So you have what? Half the Western world's supply?
There's not many. They are very rare, as you quite rightly point out. But Sacred Love by Sting can be bought as a Super Audio CD. That costs round about £6 or £7 on eBay, and it plays perfectly well in a normal CD player, but there is three elements to it. Mm. So there's the CD version, there's the SACD 2-channel stereo version, and there's the SACD 5.1 surround sound version.
Mm.
But as is always the case, unfortunately, unless you've got one of the best AV receivers in the world, it's likely that a hi-fi amplifier or something the likes of the Shangri-La Junior will be able to produce better results than the 5.1 version.
Potentially. Personally, yes. I would say if you ever want to use an AV receiver for music listening, get Marantz.
Marantz, yes, he's right.
They do the best for music.
Right. And he's totally on the nail.
For,
totally,
you know, agree. That's all, you know, 5.1 movie watching, you know, you may have different preferences, but if you want to listen to music through an AV receiver, Marantz, they're just better than everybody else's. Yamaha, I'd say, is a fairly distant second, but yeah, the rest, meh. And oh, God, Denon suck. Oh, yeah. I mean, to be honest, you switch the thing on with it. It's not going to do anything. As long as, I would say, you know, you don't have the volume turned all the way up. But then that goes without saying for all hi-fi products. You don't turn them on with the volume maxed out.
So there you can see where the volume is. So we'll just keep that down to minimum. Just while we get everything sorted out. We'll stitch our Denon on. We'll move this safely out of the way, so there's no chance that opening the drive tray or something silly like that will make the headphones fall. Just put them up there.
And I should probably just point out, whilst I don't know if it was in the box, usually if you're in Europe and you purchase one of these, it will come with a little metal enclosure, because the EU says valves are hot and you're all children and you might burn yourself, so we must protect you from it.
I don't. I mean, it was a
if you're in,
job.
Yeah, well, basically, if you're outside of Europe, I don't think it normally comes with it.
Right. Okay.
But it was something that had to be developed to pass European certification for safety, because valves get hot.
That's right, isn't it? But I'm sure I've not missed anything, have I? No. Your one hasn't come with it, unless this just come up and it may be underneath it. I don't think so. There's nothing underneath here, is there?
I don't think so. No, I mean, it may well not have come with it.
So, yeah. So, the metal grill.
Yes.
Which looks nicer without it.
Yes. I mean, to be honest, you know, whether you actually choose to use the grill is entirely up to yourself, but to be honest, I don't know anybody that actually does. Because the tubes, well, they look pretty.
But they're supplied for your safety, folks.
Yes.
Safety first always, isn't it?
Yes.
We live in a health and safety world.
Although I suppose hasn't even read the instruction manual.
Yeah, well, I suppose now that we've left the EU, I suppose we don't have to comply with that, maybe.
Oh, I can't get into that, that's it.
Okay.
So, neither of us know whether this is going to work. We're quietly confident, aren't we?
Well, it should. Yes. Assuming we've plugged things in.
So in goes Sacred Love, Super Audio CD, that logo. Quite a rare sight, I think. And we look for the SACD sign to come up here. Mm-hmm. You can see that HDMI is showing.
And what I was going to suggest is, because we have not one but two sockets there, if you wanted to, say, grab other electrostatic...
He's noticed. We do have another one. We have the J2 up here, which is an electrostatic headphone, and quite a beautiful sound.
Actually, I find it pairs with that amplifier astoundingly well. Okay. It really, really, really absolutely shines.
Well, from Mark, I think we can take that as gospel, to be honest.
Well, my default headphone that sits on my desk, although it's not at the moment, is a J2.
Okay, let's put that up here out of the way so it doesn't interfere with a Super Audio CD player. And let's plug that in. So again, we've got the arrow, so it's not exactly rocket science to just plug the thing in, is it? There we go.
No, well, it only goes in one way. It's the sort of fairly universal Stax type electrostatic plug.
So here we have SACD recognised. So it will play in the DSD SACD format rather than the 44.1. This is in DSD, which is an ultra high resolution version of the standard CD. And all we're doing is going analog out from the Super Audio CD player into the Shangri-La Junior. And we'll have a listen to the Shangri-La Junior headphones.
Yeah, like you so. Grab that one.
And as is usual for the Hi-Fi Man, is these are built-in cables, but they always face away from you. And you do have the left and right here. And as I have the world's smallest head, I need these normally set by default to the very smallest setting, but there are an awful lot of different settings which are effortless to move up and down. I'll put them on. I can already hear some output.
Yeah, and I'm just going to pop the phone down for a moment while I grab the Jade.
Let me take your camera off of you, Mark. And Mark is going to put his on.
We'll ignore the food spill stains.
So there's Mark from Hi-Fi Man putting on the cheaper but very, very nice J2 headphones. And we'll give the camera back to the cameraman there.
But yeah, the J2 as a headphone, It punches wildly above its price point for just the headphone. The issue is most people don't have an electrostatic amp already.
We're going to just do a little bit of listening now, and I will get back to you. But for a second, I'm going to get lost.
I'm going to see if there's any songs that I've ever heard of.
Wow. So we're working with some retro technology here in that we've got a Super Audio CD which is working as well as it ever has been. We're also working with tube amplification which has come back into the highest of higher end equipment, and electrostatics which are still to this day a rare commodity. So you've got lots of rare stuff, but the results are quite frankly astonishing. Let me turn this up again and get a feel for myself.
Mark, just remind the folks what these would retail at, the system, the Shangri-La Junior system, what would that retail at in the UK? Any ideas? 6,000, 8,000, 10, 12?
Well, in dollars, the system retails for $8,000.
Thank you. Okay.
In pounds, is it, I think it's 750?
Right.
I think 7, I wouldn't quote me on that because, to be honest, I normally do every. I'm just completely used to pricing everything in dollars. I use dollars all the time, and so when it comes to the UK prices, normally I have to run away and actually look them up.
Okay. Well, from we can get an idea, a taste, if you like, as to what sort of level of the market these are at. And as you know, I've spoken to you all about Hi-Fi Man headphones that retail at £149 that I really like. So what do I listen for or do I feel when I switch on something that goes from £150 to £7,500? And once we get to this level of quality in a headphone, we start to lose the thought of listening to a piece of hi-fi equipment. And instead of imagining that you're listening to a piece of hi-fi equipment, you can say, well, the treble might be slightly sharp, the sound stage is a bit compressed, the bass is a bit overdone, the mids are a bit recessed. You start losing those sort of descriptions, and we start really talking about something that transcends the term hi-fi.
And I think
you start
the truest
listening to music.
Yeah, I think the truest form of absolute high-end hi-fi is where you start off, where you're listening to the equipment, you're looking for all the technicalities of what it can and can't do. And as the time passes, you find yourself just becoming lost in the music that you love. And you stop listening to it and you stop paying, which is one of the reasons why I cannot have a Shangri-La Senior as my day-to-day, because if I did, I would absolutely never get any work done whatsoever. All I would do is listen to it. You just become lost.
Yes, and we've got this turned down quite a way now, but this, for background music, as we're presenting your unboxing of the Shangri-La Junior, is quite bizarre feeling, I'm sure, for both of us. So I think Mark's hit the nail on the head. The music takes over the whole feeling of listening for inadequacies or changes to the sound beyond being able to compare it to anything else. This is the Shangri-La Junior, and the comparison to the Shangri-La Junior would be a Shangri-La Junior that didn't work, and this one, we're pleased to tell you all, folks, works perfectly.
Yes, it survived FedEx trouble-free.
What we want Mark and myself to do now, what we're going to do is, obviously, we've got a J2 on, which understandably retails at quite a lower price point than the Shangri-La Junior. We're going to spend 30 seconds now. We'll crank it up to a normal listening volume, and then we'll quickly swap the two over and see if we can find anything that we can talk to you about as the difference between the J2.
Well, I could do that now.
And its big brother, the Shangri-La Junior. So we're now going to do the swap. So Mark gets the Shangri-La Junior and Trev gets the Jade 2. So there we are.
Which one of the things, if we can just catch, Trevor, if you could just generally to the way the driver covering iridesces, I just love on the Jade. Goes from green, and if Trevor turns, it'll go from still green, and there it goes to kind of purple.
Again, we've got a subjective opinion here because obviously Mark's got the Shangri-La Junior on. I've now got the Jade 2 on. I'm a particular fan of the Jade 2 anyway. However, obviously when we're talking about the Shangri-La Junior, and I've just had a quick list to the Jade 2 there. Ostensibly, you'd feel that there was nothing whatsoever wrong with the effortless, smooth presentation of the Jade 2. Until, of course, you put on the Shangri-La Junior. And if you can imagine a flannel being put over something, and then without any noticeable lifting off, suddenly there would be the Shangri-La Junior in front of you. So in terms of the technicality of the Shangri-La Junior, it is able to present more music, but with the same smooth presentation and the sound stage and the detail opens up, and the J2 is no slouch at that, but the Hi-Fi Man Junior takes it to another level, the Shangri-La Junior. And I will keep saying to the Shangri-La Junior, because between you and me, folks, we will have yet something else to present to you during the course of this particular few days. So this is the Shangri-La Junior, which means there could well be something beyond the Shangri-La Junior. Could there be a senior? So the J2 is beautiful, effortless presentation, and I could listen to this forever and be perfectly happy until you're presented with the Shangri-La Junior. And this is Hi-Fi Man's typical way of just unveiling more and unveiling more and peeling away yet more layers and more layers, that until you get to this level, you never realise were there. Let's switch it up again. A few more seconds and then we'll do another swap.
Although, if I may just mention, the world's number one audio enhancement tool.
Yes. Yes, indeed. Red wine.
Mm. I would say either red wine or scotch.
Told like a true Scot. So let's put that on there for you.
Almost on back. Oh.
So perhaps the Stax Lander to the J2 is a stream to a pond. The J2 to the Shangri-La Junior, a pond to a river. Beyond a river, there's an ocean. But perhaps we might go into that at some date in the future.
Yes, I'm sure nobody will guess from the very subtle hints.
So ladies and gents, I think we've bored you long enough with the Shangri-La Junior unboxing, but it's been absolutely fantastic to bring these to you, and I'm so pleased that they survived the journey intact. We've got it all set up and it sounds absolutely superb. If you're sat on the fence about buying these, why are you hesitating? If you've got the money to do it, they won't bury you with it. Use it for something decent.
Yeah.
Live the life.
It's what credit cards were invented for.
Yes, wise words from Hi-Fi Man there. I'm sure they
Not
know.
That we're suggesting anyone should go into debt to buy products, but, you know, if you want to.
Well, another health and safety warning wisely put in there, Mark. Thank you very much.
Oh, yes, because, you know, because otherwise somebody will sue you.
From Mark at Hi-Fi Man, who's my intrepid cameraman and given some expert advice to us all, and from myself, Trev, the Geekologist, thank you very much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again very soon.